वेलकम टू ओरिजिन्स एपिसोड 16 इनफेमस लास्ट वर्ड्स गैरी गिलमोर. गैरी वॉज नॉट अ नाइस मैन. गैरी ऑल्सो हैड अ वेरी ट्रबल्ड चाइल्डहुड. इन लाइट ऑफ ऑल द रीसेंट मास शूटिंग स्टोरीज इन द US, इट माइट बी वाइज टू टर्न बैक द क्लॉक एंड लुक एट इंसिडेंट्स लाइक गैरीज एंड लुक एट द इफेक्ट अ रॉटन चाइल्डहुड कुड हैव लेटर इन लाइफ. It might save these individuals and those around them. There's even a Netflix show about this, Mindhunter. Anyway, back to Gary. He was born in Texas in 1940. He was a product of an impulse wedding between an alcoholic dad and a runaway Mormon, who probably didn't realize at the time the impact their child would have, directly and indirectly. Gary had a difficult childhood, full of abuse by his alcoholic and often violent dad. After a few years, when he was still young, Gary's family relocated to Portland, Oregon. Now, I personally know the city of Portland, Oregon for two things. One, it's supposedly a hipster paradise, best exemplified by the show Portlandia. You should check it out. It's full of references to people doing weird things and overdosing on all things organic and gluten-free and having weird hobbies and generally being a liberal hippie paradise and stuff like that. But that is now. When Gary's family got there, it probably was not any of these things. In fact, Gary started doing low-level crime here. At the age of 14, he got together a little gang that specialized in car theft. At the age of 14, he promptly got caught and arrested. He became increasingly better at avoiding the law and upping the level of crime he committed. Armed robbery followed. And all this while, he kept getting caught by the law, sent to correctional facilities that had little or no impact on Gary. By the age of 35, he was a fully fledged criminal, and this is when things went up a notch and not in the nice way. On July 19th, 1976, Gary Gilmore robbed and murdered a young man called Max Jensen, who left behind a widow and a child. The very next day, Gary robbed and murdered another young man called Benny Bushnell, who also left behind a widow and child. He then accidentally shot himself in the arm and, thanks to a tip from his own cousin, was apprehended and handed over to the police for the very last time. Gary Gilmore, by the way, is no relation at all to the two-match wonder Australian fast bowler most famous for picking up 11 wickets in two games in the semi-final and the final of the 1979 World Cup. I just thought I'd clear that up. Gilmore, the Portland murderer, his trial became a sensation, not only because of his heartless murders, but because he welcomed the death penalty that was given to him. In fact, he vehemently opposed anyone who tried to get him off with just a life sentence. When he learned that the ACLU, the American Civil Liberties Union, was trying to help him reduce his death sentence to a life imprisonment, he rejected the help, saying, "They always want to get in on the act. I don't think they have ever done anything effective in their lives. I would like them all, including that group of reverends and rabbis from Salt Lake City, to butt out. This is my life and this is my death. It's been sanctioned by the courts that I die and I accept that." End quote. Well, fair. So insistent was he on dying that he even attempted to commit suicide twice while on death row, thinking that some meddling liberal group or the other might try to get him off. Gary was presented with two death options, hanging or firing. He chose the latter, saying that he believed a hanging could be botched. Again, fair. Finally, on January 19th, 1977, Gary Gilmore was executed by firing squad at Utah State Prison. He was given a last meal, asked for his last words, and after being shot, was administered last rites. He was 36. Phew. Now, you must be wondering what brand I'm going to talk about here, right? I mean, which brand could possibly have this horrendous story as its origin, and where lies the origin? Well, the answer to that lies in the second thing that I know about Portland, Oregon. You remember, a while back I said I knew two things, and one thing was them being a hipster paradise? Well, the second thing that I know about Portland is that it's home to one of the most revered cult advertising agencies of all time, called Wieden & Kennedy. And Wieden, Dan Wieden, was reading about this case, the Gary Gilmore murder, while he was working on a new client who was, at the time, searching for a tagline. And like in all advertising agencies, Dan was working against a deadline. He said, In reviewing the work the night before the client presentation, I felt we needed a tagline to give some unity to the work. So Dan looked at the last words uttered by Gary and tweaked it just a little bit and said, yeah, that'd work. And didn't have too much expectations from that, really. It might have been a late-night last-ditch effort, but it was a tagline that resonated around the world, helped Dan's client become one of the biggest brands of all time, and helped cement his agency, Wieden & Kennedy, as one of the best in the world. For indeed, when asked if he had any last words before getting shot, Gary Gilmore, the murderer, had just three words to say: let's do it. And all that Dan did was to change that first word and say, yeah, that'll work. And so there you have it. The last words of a cold-hearted murderer ended up changing the fortunes of a small shoe manufacturer, a fledgling ad agency, and inspiring millions of athletes and would-be athletes from around the world to go and just do it. See you next week for another origin story.